Hello everyone and welcome to my tutorial for today. I'm still your friend the needle woman and I hope you guys are okay. So today we're going to be doing a very quick one. It is a highly requested video. It is the construction of a perfect armhole, alright? And that is what we shall be doing today. But first I need to show you how to measure your armhole depth, okay? Now this is my measuring tape. You have to place your tape like so. Run it across your armhole. You make sure it touches your armhole, and when it does, whatever it gives you, you add 1 inch to it for ease. You can see mine is 17. I have to add another one to make it 18 inches. I hope you can see it, just for ease. I wouldn't want it to be just glued to my armhole like so. All right so you see I added 1 more inch for ease, making it 18. That is 9 inches altogether, 18 inches. Okay, with that said, we'll now go straight to how to construct the perfect armhole. Okay, so these are the necessary information you need to know in constructing your armhole. You have the small, the medium, the large size, the XL and double XL sizes on this side. Now if you are size small, it means your bust measurement is falling between 24 and 28. For medium, 28 to 36. For large, 36 to 44. For XL and XXL, 44 and above. Now for the armhole connection for the front armhole, for a small size of either 24 to 28, you have 1 inch. For 28 to 36, you have 3/4 of an inch. For 36 and 44, 1/2 an inch. For XL and double XL, 1/4 inch. Okay, now with this done, I will now go straight to talk about how to construct the armhole. First, I'll be talking about the lazy method of constructing the armhole measurement. All right, and here we go. You mark the starting point, which I have already ruled the line here. You measure your shoulder out. Mine is 8 inches. That is 16. My paper is unfolded. 16 here. Okay. The neckline, 3 inches. Sorry, the shoulder slope. The 3 inches is for the shoulder slope. Okay. The shoulder slope, I will use 1/2 an inch. Okay, now from the shoulder slope, I need to measure my shoulder. I need to measure the volume of my armhole, which is 9 inches. Okay, 8 inches. I will now put this into a straight line. I will slope my shoulder at this point. Okay. Now you need to find the midpoint between this shoulder slope. We are no longer making use of this place. You find the midpoint between here and here. This is our armhole area. That is the depth of our armhole. And since my armhole is 9 inches, the midpoint is 4.5, which is here. Okay, now I need to measure 1/4 of my bust. Assuming I am working with this measurement this large and my bust is 44, the 1/4 of 44 is 11. That's divided by 4. We have 11 here. Okay, let's not forget this is armhole depth. Okay, now we have to assume also that this remaining one is our seam allowance or sewing allowance. Okay, now with that done, for this lazy method, all you need to do is at this point move inwards by 1 inch and then connect this line to your shoulder slope. Okay, and maintain still the midpoint. Okay, now with this done, you use your French curve to connect first to this place and then to our bust measurement. This is what I mean with your French curve. I'm sorry I don't have it, but I'm sure you will get what I'm doing. So this now is our front armhole. Okay. And this should be our back. Okay, so this is the lazy method. Now, if you are cutting, you will need to cut the back first of all. And then the front. Okay, so this is it, the front and the back. All right, now if you are using this method, remember that when you are cutting your sleeve, you have to consider this. Okay, you make the same adjustment on your sleeve. For those people that use this, personally I don't use it. All right, so we are now going to talk about the professional way of constructing our armhole, not this lazy type of construction. Alright, so this is the professional way. First, you draw your line. This is going to be a starting point. Okay. You measure the shoulder length, which is 8 inches. I'll still be using the 8 inches, but this time I'm working with XL or double XL. Okay. You mark also your shoulder slope. First, 3 inches, and then shoulder slope of either 1 inch or 1/2 inch, it depends on you, but I'll be using 1/2 inch. You connect it with a straight line. This is still my shoulder. I just want the line to be straight. Okay, now you need to mark the armhole depth. Okay, I will still be using 9 inches, but if you measure that person or you measure yourself and it's more than 9 inches, you will need to do that here. 9 inches, I will draw it into a straight line. Okay. You measure 1/4 of your bust. So I would like to use 46 inches as my bust here, since I used 44 here. So here I'll be using 46 inches, and the 1/2 of 46 inches is 11.5, which is here. Let's also consider that this is allowance, this little one here, but if you are putting this on your fabric, you need to increase the allowance. Okay, so we have to draw this one out. This is where our armhole ended, right? And this is the 1/4 of the bust I'm working with, which is 46 inches. Now we need to mark the midpoint at this armhole, which is 4.5, since it is 9 inches. The next thing should be to connect the midpoint to the actual bust measurement, not to the allowance. Now this is our actual bust measurement. All you need is to connect this one to our midpoint. Now if you don't have a French curve, just move in by 2 inches from this and go 90 and then connect. Okay, now this is for the back. Now since we said that for the armhole connection for the front, it is 1/4 inches, all you need to do is to go in by 1/4 of an inch here at the midpoint. This is 1/4 of an inch. Connect it to the slope here and down to the armhole to the bust measurement also. This is what I mean. I'm sorry, I don't have a French curve, but I just needed to clear somebody on this. Okay, so now this is the front armhole, and this is the back armhole. Okay. Also, you cut the back armhole first of all. This is the slope, and then you remove the front. So basically what we are saying is, if your measurement is between 28 and 36 for this front, you are moving in by 3/4 of an inch. Okay, if it is 24 to 28, you are moving in by 1 inch. I hope it's very clear. Thank you for watching till the end. I appreciate you guys. Till we meet in my next tutorial, I love you from the bottom of my heart. Take very good care of yourself. I love you.